Gould was brought up according to strict puritanical principles.
The most vivid of my childhood memories in connection with Toronto have to do with churches. They have to do with Sunday evening services, with evening light filtered through stained glass windows, and with ministers who concluded their benediction with the phrase,
"Lord, give us the peace that the earth cannot give."
Monday mornings, you see, meant that one had to go back to school and encounter all sorts of terrifying situations out there in the city. So those moments of Sunday evening sanctuary became very special to me. They meant that one could find a certain tranquility even in the city, but only if one opted not to be part of it.
Gould's spiritual experiences from his childhood stayed with him throughout his life. For example, his love of the English Renaissance composer Orlando Gibbons.
Well, I can't think of anybody who represents the end of an era better than Orlando Gibbons does. There is a spiritual attachment that I began to feel for his music when I first heard some of the anthems. I fell in love with them. Orlando Gibbons is my favorite composer, always has been.
Glorious and powerful Lord, we understand.
According to French poet Baudelaire, genius is nothing more than childhood rediscovered. Do you agree, Mr. Gould?
Glenn,
do you agree with Baudelaire, Glenn?
You mean, once a Puritan, always a Puritan?
Yes, something like that. After all, you once referred to yourself as the last Puritan.
Did I?
Indeed you did, thinking of the novel of the same name by George Santayana. By the same token, you appointed your maternal grandmother, Mary Catherine Gregg, as the main witness for the Puritan view of art, according to which, I quote, "Art is an instrument of salvation, the artist, a missionary advocate to hold the forces of darkness at bay." Is that the role you see yourself in, Glenn? The role of a missionary and a harbinger?
So you think I see myself in a role?
Definitely. By the way, do you have to answer every question with another question?
Do I do that? Oh, sorry. Well, okay, maybe you're right. But let's talk about something else now.
For example?
I don't know. Why don't you suggest something?